Transportation in plants. Plants have slow transport systems because of their low energy need. In plants, the materials are mainly transported in two pathways. 1. Food materials from the site of production to the site of storage, that is, from leaf to stem or root. This conductive tissue is called phloem. The transport of the soluble product of photosynthesis from the leaf to other parts is called translocation. The translocation of food and other substances take place in the sieve tubes with the help of adjacent companion cells, both in upward and downward directions. The translocation in phloem is achieved by utilizing energy. Materials like sucrose is transferred in phloem tissue using energy from ATP. This increases the osmotic pressure of the tissue, causing water to move into it. This pressure moves the material in the phloem to tissues which have less pressure. This allows the phloem to move material according to the plant's needs. For example, in the spring, sugar stored in root or stem tissue would be transported to the buds which need energy to grow. 2. Water and minerals are conducted from root to other body parts through a specialized tissue called xylem. It consists of vessels and tracheids through which roots, stems, and leaves are interconnected to form a continuous system of water-conducting channels. At the roots, cells in contact with the soil actively take up ions. This creates a difference in the concentration of these ions between the root and the soil. Water, therefore, moves into the root from the soil to eliminate this difference. The effect of root pressure in transport of water is more important at night. During the day, when the stomata are open, the transpiration pull becomes the major driving force in the movement of water in the xylem.